we've seen, one function can call another function. For example, myRand called the built-in functions rand and sum. But built-in functions don't have to be involved at all. Our own functions can call each other as well. We could, for example, define a function called Bob, which we saved into bob.m, and a function Mary, which we saved into mary.m. Then Bob could call Mary, or Mary could call Bob. Furthermore, we can define multiple functions in the same M file and have them call each other. Why, you may ask, would we put two functions in the same file? Well, if the problem we're trying to solve is complicated, we'll want to break it up into several functions. But if those functions are not likely to be useful for solving other problems, then it makes sense to keep them all in the same M file. Let's see an example. Let's rewrite the last version of myRand. Let's see. We'll leave all this the same. But we're going to get rid of this. Instead of calling sum here, we're going to call sum all elements. Now that's not a built-in function, so where is it going to come from? Well, we're going to put it right here. Let me get rid of this end statement. We're going to put it right here in the same file. I got rid of the end statement because if you have more than one function in a file, either they all have to have end statements or none of them can have end statements, and it's extra typing, so I just got rid of it. We've created a separate function for summing up the elements. This is, of course, a very simple example, and there's not much of an advantage to doing this here, but later we'll see examples when it matters. In any case, you can see how simple the syntax is. The second function keyword, right here, indicates that the first function has ended and the second one has begun. Functions that are defined in the same file like this behave in most respects just like other functions. The only difference is that only the first function up here, which is called the main function, can be called by other functions outside the file. The other functions, in this case we only have one, are called subfunctions or local functions, and they can only be called by functions inside the file. Like other functions, all their variables are local, and this means that the variables in a function are unavailable to the command window and unavailable to all other functions, whether or not they're in the same file. So V is not available inside myRand, A is not available inside sumAllElements, and none of these variables are available down here inside the command window. Well, let's see if this thing works. Let's see, we'll do the same exact command that we did before we made the change. There. Works. The only way to exchange information between these functions is with input and output arguments. In this case, when we call some elements from inside myRand, we use A as an input argument to pass its value into sum all elements. That value, which happens to be a 3x4 array, is copied from A into the input argument M inside sum all elements. Note that we calculated the sum of the elements of the 3x4 array, which is in M, the same way as we did it before, but this time the calculation is done inside sum all elements, and the array that we're working on is inside the variable M. Note that we can't use the variable A here inside sum all elements. We can't because it's a local variable of myRand. And the local variables of myRand are unavailable inside other functions. Okay, so we pass the array into sum all elements via an input argument. And after we calculate the sum, we need to send that sum back to myRand. Well, inside sum all elements, this local variable summa is declared right here to be an output argument. So that means when sum all elements is done and closes, the contents of that summa, which is the sum we want, will appear right here in myRand where sum all elements was invoked. And then it'll be copied into S, and when myRand ends, then that'll go back to the command window, or whoever called this function myRand. The passing of information via input and output arguments when one function calls another is the same for any function, whether it be a subfunction or not, and whether it's a built-in function or not. Okay, so that's how this thing works. You can put as many subfunctions in an M file as you want, but the first function you should remember is always the only one that can be called from outside.